Who you want? Who you like? Baby, tell me who you loving. Last time I checked. What's going on, Bella Gang? It's your girl, Lover Natural, back at it again with a brand new Girl Talk video. Bella Gang, best friends, in this Girl Talk video, I'm going to be giving you guys my best possible advice, my best key tips in moving out and going into your own apartment, as well as, you know, learning how to save your money, how to pay all your bills, and everything in this video. I feel like this video is very important because maybe you're 18 and you're thinking about moving into your own place. You don't know what to expect. Maybe it's your first time. You don't gotta be 18. It's your first time moving into your own place. You don't know what to expect. I got you, because this is literally my third apartment that I ever got. So I know everything there needs to know about saving and moving into your first apartment. I know how exciting it can be. So before you even move into your apartment, please watch this video. Without further ado, we're gonna get right into this video. Don't forget to thumbs up this video, like, comment, subscribe. If you're new to my channel, hey girl, hey, welcome to the Bella Gang. Please subscribe to me and click the notification bell right next to the subscribe button so that every time I upload, you'll be notified. Okay, love you so much, and let's get right into this video. Okay, Bella Gang, let's get started with tip number one. So when I first initially moved out and got my own place, I was about 20, 21. And I had a waitressing job, but luckily when you have a waitressing job, you get paid every day. You don't get a paycheck every week or every 2 weeks. Literally, from you get the tips that you get at the end of the night, you can save. So I thought to myself, you know what? Good, I can finally have enough money to get my own place and pay all my bills. That is very important. Don't go and get an apartment and just think to yourself, oh, I got $5,000 saved up. That's good for 2 months. You know what I'm saying? No. First of all, you want to have money. For me, I had 5 months rent ahead of time. I saved $5,000 or something like that. I saved up for my apartment. But you got to find an apartment that is within your budget. You don't want to go over budget or get something too expensive where, you know, you could afford your bills and your rent, but you can never go out with your friends because you're always broke. I know myself, I used to literally, when my sisters would be like, oh, let's go out. I'd be like, no, I got to pay my rent. I got to pay my rent. Even though I had saved up $5,000, it wasn't enough, because once I paid my rent for those few months, I found myself struggling trying to make ends meet, because if you work as a waitress, then you know during the summertime, it's really, really slow. So my bills was piling up, honey, and I end up making payment arrangements on my cable bill, on my phone bill, and then I just had it up to here with my bills to where I freaking moved back with my mom. Yeah, I end up moving back with my mom. Not with my first apartment, but my last apartment, I ended up moving back with my mom just to grind a little bit more, to make more money so I could live a certain lifestyle. Because like I said, you know, it's not easy when you have your own place and you have your bills coming at you at once. You might think you have it under control, but what if you lose your job? Or what if your job is not paying as much as it did before? Because that was my case. That was the reason why I ended up moving in with my mom, because I was not making enough money. I was not making enough money. I can pay my bills and my rent and stuff, but I didn't have extra money. So when my siblings would ask me to go out, or friends, I'd be like, I don't got it. Spending $30 on a meal was just too much for me. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't even have an iPhone. I had a Metro PCS phone, because I couldn't even afford an iPhone. And that is not how anyone should live. You don't want to live to pay bills, okay? I know that's adulthood, that's adult life, you all pay bills, but you want to make sure that how much your rent and your bills is, you're making way more than that. You know, you're bringing in more than that so that you can be able to pay your bills, go grocery shopping, go regular shopping, get your nails, your feet done without feeling like, damn, I need to pay my cable. I can't even treat myself, because that's going to put you in a really great depression. I was very depressed when I moved into my last place. The first place I got was actually a room for rent. And I noticed that I was actually more happier when I had that room for rent, because it was only $150 a week and it was utilities included. And I was 21 at the time when I got that. And I was able to go out with my friends, I still had that waitressing job. So 150, what? That was nothing to shell out every week. But when I moved into my apartment that I could no longer like really afford, my last apartment that I'm telling you guys that I was like depressed about because all my money was going to my rent and my bills, that rent was like $1,000. So it was a big difference. And that's why I said it's very important that, you know, you get a place that you can not only afford, but you can still maintain your own lifestyle and still go out and not feel like, you know, your apartment is a burden to you. Because once you feel like your apartment is a burden to you, you no longer can really enjoy it. You know what I'm saying? And on top of that, if you have your own place and you messing with a man that can't even help you with a bill or two, take a trash bag and throw him away. Because you don't want, you know, no, because dudes love it when you say you have your own crib. Because they know they could come on, you know what I'm saying? Go on your bed, y'all do the do. No, even to this day, nope. I'm not dating right now, and if I do have a boyfriend, like, you know, I'm not saying like, all right, you gotta pay my bills because he does not live here. But if I do fall short and I need something paid, he should be paying a bill or two. Don't let society make you feel like you're a gold digger. No, you're not. Because if you're single and if you're in a relationship and you're struggling, you're single, sis. Period. So I know I'm going off track here because there's so much I want to tell you guys because I have so much experience with this. But bear with me. I'm gonna get to the point. So when I first moved out, when I was 21, I had a room for rent. I paid $150. I was able to pay all my bills and then some. Had a gym membership and everything, living my best life. Then I moved to my next place, and it was $1,000 a month, and I had to pay my bills, and it was just too much. You know what's crazy? I wasn't even prepared to move into that place. You have to prepare yourself, because if you don't, you're just gonna be in hella debt. Like, I moved in not having money for furniture because I'm like, oh, I could just buy furniture. Like, for how much does furniture cost? It's not that much. Furniture is very expensive to the point where I remember I had got like my first bedroom set from Rent-A-Center because it was only like $40 a week for the furniture. And like, you pay it off like that, like a $2,000 furniture, you just pay $40 a week. But if you're paying your furniture $40 a week, and let's say you get a place that utility is not included, so you gotta pay for cable, you gotta pay for water, you gotta pay for gas on top of your rent, how are you gonna survive? You know what I'm saying? Don't try to impress people and get a nice lavish apartment that you cannot afford to upkeep. So it's very important. What I would've told my younger self is to, girl, I know this apartment is gorgeous because everyone who came to that apartment used to tell me like, oh my God, it's so beautiful. And I used to love the fact that I was young and I had my own place. You know, that was going on my second place because when I had the room for rent, I really wanted my own apartment because I had a roommate and she was nasty as fuck. She was like 40 years old, bringing guys, different random guys back and forth. I just had to go. And I didn't even know her. When you rent a room, you don't necessarily know the person. The landlord just rents it to you. It was beautiful. It looked like an apartment, but we shared the same bathroom and kitchen. And, you know, I just had to get out of there. So I felt like, okay, God bless me with an apartment. But it was too expensive for me. And I noticed that I was keeping up with my bills. I was never evicted. By the grace of God, I wasn't evicted. But, you know, I felt like I was trying to keep my head above water and, like, just not being able to maintain it. I wasn't happy no more because I couldn't go out with my friends, like I said. And if you're young, if you're watching this, it's because you're probably young, you want your own place. Keep that in mind, that you need not a lot of money, but you need money in your savings account. You need emergency money. And when you have your own place, like when you move into your apartment, like, always have your rent money like 2 months ahead. So what I mean by that is, let's say when I get paid, right? I make sure before I even spend money on anything, I have 2 months rent. So just in case of anything, any emergency where something happens, I don't have enough or whatever, I know I can go in my savings and I have my rent money in my savings. And it's very important to have your rent money more than your utilities, because your light could be off, your cable could be off. But once you don't got your rent money, your landlord do not want to hear that. I remember like I got into it with my landlord because I was like $30 short, but I really didn't have it like that. And I felt like, you know, and when you don't have your rent money, your landlord looks at you and just start disrespecting you. You know, when people have to come and knock on your door for the rent, you know what I'm saying? You guys are going to end up being in a lot of verbal arguments, and next you know, it could get physical. Luckily, that didn't happen for me. I just said, you know what? I'm done with this. I'm gonna move into my mom's house and start over. But some people can't just move into your parents' house and start over. So, you know, learn from my mistakes. If you cannot afford an apartment, don't get it yet. I don't care how bad your circumstances is, because your circumstances will get worse if you just move into an apartment and just think that because you have $4,000 saved up, that you're good. No. Before you move in an apartment, if you cannot afford like to pay your rent and then have another rent money saved in your savings account, then you're not ready to move into an apartment. I mean, you don't wanna live paycheck to paycheck and pay month to month. Even me, I feel like altogether, I think my bills is probably like 600 probably for utilities and everything, a little bit more or less, I'm not sure. But I always make sure that I have like my rent and like my bills for the next month in my savings account, because that's just how I move. And I feel like with this economy, look how the government shutdown happened, and a lot of people that work for the federal government, you know, they were either getting evicted from their homes you know, they were devastated. And that's something that I think about all the time. You know, I actually didn't start doing this until I found out about the federal the government shutdown, because that's scary. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to go from living a certain way to now not knowing where you're going to sleep at night. That's very scary. And that's why I strongly suggest that you ladies or guys, you're very responsible with your money. A lot of young people, we're not responsible with our money. And we think, oh, we're going to get paid again, it's fine. No. If you know that you need $100 to pay your cable bill, it's due next week, but you want your nails done now, guess what? Wait, pay your cable bill, wait until you get paid again, then get your nails done. You got to put your priorities first. All of that, those are luxuries. That's not a necessity. You want to, and especially, don't forget about it if you want to get a car. Me, I don't have a purpose for a car because I live in New York and I take Ubers everywhere. I'm going to end up getting a car. But once again, I want to make sure that my means of income is straight before I go and add another bill, because I don't want just any hoopty. I want a nice car. So if I want a nice car, I put in my head, all right, that's an extra $1,000 or more a month on the car note and the insurance. Can you afford it? And just because you can afford something doesn't mean that you should just always get it either. Where's my water? So thirsty, you know? I hope I'm not all over the place, guys. Like I said, I've been on my own for like 6 years now. So, minus the year that I spent with my mom. But I know everything that there needs to know about apartments and saving and stuff like that. So, saving is very important. Before you even move in your apartment, not only saving, but make sure that you have enough in your savings to cover your rent for the next month and enough money to cover your bills for the next month. And guess what? Don't touch that money. Let it pile up. That's the best way to save money, because you know that, like let's say your bill is your rent is like $650, because that's how much my rent was before. I had an apartment and it was $650 before. So I would save up, what is it, like $1,300? Yeah, I would save up like $1,300, because I know that, okay, I have $650 for the rent this month and $650 for next month just in case. So when next month comes and everything's okay and I'm able to pay my bills regularly, I add another $650. So now I have $1,300 in my savings account, and you get my drift, and keep doing that every month. Now you're gonna have a good savings, and you know that in case of a rainy day, you could take from your savings and pay your bills. Okay, so if you wanna save money and you wanna have like a lump sum of money, don't just say, okay, I'm saving, so let me put $50, let me put $100. That's not money. That's not money. You got to put a large amount of money. So I read this somewhere. I saw it on a show probably. But always save more than you spend. So let's say you have $1,000. Take $400 to yourself and save $600. And I know it's probably so hard and difficult because we always want to go out and treat ourselves and go shopping. But what's more? Would you rather spend $2,000 on like a Fendi shirt, or would you rather have $2,000 in your account. So just in case for emergency, you always got it. Because, you know, I don't know about you, but I hate asking people for money. I hate asking people for handouts. I love God, and God tells me, honey, that you, my child, is a lender and not a borrower. You know what I'm saying? Another way I noticed that I save my money, or I make lots of more money, this is off topic, is that every first of the month, I always tithe. I give 10% in church. I give 10%. Or sometimes, if I don't give that 10%, like whether it's $300 or $400, I might give it to somebody in need randomly in the street. Like, that's what I do. Or I give it to a family member that I know that really needs it. But I always take 10% of my income and give it back to God, just to show God, like, thank you. And when I tell you that scripture is nothing but the truth, you reap what you sow. If you reap grudgingly, you will also receive grudgingly. If you sow a good seed, you will see an abundance. And, you know, I'm not trying to shove God down anybody's throats, or if you don't believe in God or tithing, you don't have to do this. But if you do tithe and you do believe in God, comment below if I'm not lying right over here, if I'm telling the truth. Because I noticed that when I didn't tithe, I would be struggling. But when I do tithe and be like, and just give it and don't regret it, just give it, I'm always good. God always provides for me. And speaking of God, even when I was in my rough times, because my mom didn't have it, my sisters didn't have it to lend it to me, lend me some rent money to pay my bills, I literally had to grind myself. And if it wasn't for God, I don't know where I would be, because I used to just pray to God, please, like, let me just get my rent money, God. Let me get this together. And, like, for instance, this is so scary. I would pray, God, I need $100 more for my rent, and I will work as a waitress. And then my first shift, like my first table, gives me like $100 cash tip. Like, you know, I think something told me to give this to you. Woo! I feel goosebumps right now. Like, I don't know about you guys, I feel goosebumps right now, because God is so real. Comment below if that happens to you, where you really in hard times, you really need something, and just the perfect time, God comes through for you in miraculous ways, mysterious ways. That's why I truly believe when God blesses you, you have to be a blessing to others. That's why I want to start cash apping my Bella Gang subscribers money and stuff like that, because you guys, I feel like, you know, you deserve it, you know. And on top of that, you know, I like to give without receiving. I really like being a giver. That's why I can't wait till one day I become a millionaire, because I'm gonna be the first millionaire in my family. I feel it. I'm gonna speak to existence. And when I am a millionaire, come back to this video. I'm gonna make sure that, you know, my word is my bond. I'm gonna make sure that I help many people and change a lot of lives, because God changed my life in a miraculous way. And I went from struggling to being, you know, okay and financially stable. And I'm so grateful for that, because there have been times where I ask people for money, you know, and they can't give it to me. Especially a guy, that's a major turnoff. If I don't ask you for anything, but I really need it, and you say no, you don't need to be in my contact list anymore. I'm sorry. Like, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? If my friend asks me for money, I want to be able to give my friend, like, here you go, because I know how it is. I know the struggle is real. So, and with that being said, before you move into an apartment, I know it's exciting and everything, and you want to have people coming over and stuff like that. That's another thing. Don't have everybody over your house, because, you know, a friend today could be an enemy tomorrow. You don't want everybody knowing where you lay your head at. Next, you know, you got to move because your house is getting shot at, or, you know, girls is coming up to you trying to fight. That's another thing. So if you're young, I know a lot of young people want to have get-togethers. They want to have parties and stuff. You want to make sure that, you know, you invite the right company. Watch. Be careful of the company you keep. I'm telling you this, I feel like a mother, but it's true. When my mom used to tell me this, I didn't believe it until I had crazy-ass exes showing up to my door. It's true. And I'm sorry, guys. You know when you talk a lot and you get that white thing over here? I hate it. Ew. Okay. Yeah, be careful of the company you keep. And on top of that, if you're moving out into your own place and you're a young girl, just make sure that you keep the noise down. You don't blast your music, because you don't want nobody calling the cops on you, and you don't want your landlord telling you got to move out a month after you moved in because you make so much noise, you got people coming in and out. You know, let your house be a house of just zen. peace and quiet. If me personally, I live in a building complex. I don't blast music, and nobody in this building blasts music too. Everybody respects each other, and I really, really like that. You don't want to be that, or let's say you're living on a top floor, make sure that you're light when you're walking on your feet. My mom used to always say that in Creole. What is it? Well, I'm gonna translate it in English because my Creole is bad, but stop jumping on the people's head. You know what I'm saying? yeah, and I used to be like, why she always care about that when we used to live in an apartment? And it's because you wanna be like respectful. You know what I'm saying? And my last landlord, I actually ran into him and we had a good conversation. He was like, you know, you was like the best tenant I ever had. And when you moved in, I didn't even want to give you the place because you were so young. You was like 20 and I only rent out spaces to like older people. And it's crazy because the roommate that I was telling you guys about, the 40-year-old, she was the one that was acting like she was my age. She never cleaned. The garbage was up to here. I used to always have to clean. I had to tell him. I'm like, I got to leave because I can't live like this. And he was like, you know, you was more responsible than she was. And I really appreciate that. You want to always leave a good rapport with everyone you come in contact with when you live with them. You know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, my landlord, after him, we end up arguing because she did some snake shit to me. And you guys know I'm a good person. I don't disrespect anyone that doesn't disrespect me first. And on top of that, you know, I had to deal with her coming into my home when I was not there and coming into my home, not when I was not there, coming to my home when I was there. Like I heard the key and then I'm like, who? I thought it was like intruder and it was my landlord in my goddamn house. And she looked at me shocked like, yeah, like bitch, what are you doing in my apartment? That's another reason why I have to leave. You know what I'm saying? You want to make sure that when you move into an apartment that it's very, you know, it's safe and that your landlord respects where you live. Be careful about, I'd rather you live in an apartment like building than living in a private home because I live in a private home. That's why she felt so comfortable to bring her ass in my house. You know what I'm saying? Whenever she felt like it. And also, I knew her because she was my sister's friend's mom. And that's another conflict of interest. You don't want to move with anybody that you know because I'm sorry, you're bound to have an argument with that person. It's just the inevitable. It's gonna happen, and especially if they're your landlord, if you have money issues, you guys can turn it from friends to enemies real fast. I saw on the news that this tenant and this landlord got into it over $200, and the freaking landlord, this happened in Brooklyn. Comment below if you remember the story. The landlord in Brooklyn, instead of just like letting her go or whatever or taking her to court, she beat the lady to death and she dismembered her body, cut her body up in Brooklyn for over $200. Now she's probably spending like life in prison. So you don't want to get into it with your landlord. And, you know, and make sure that they respect where you live and you pay your money on time so that you can be respected. You know what I'm saying? Another tip I have if you're moving to your own place, like I said, furniture is very expensive. I was paying Rent-A-Center, but like I said, I didn't really have it like that. So I noticed that I was paying so much bills that I didn't have enough for myself. So you want to have at least $5,000. $5,000 to get, you know, a bedroom set. And also, bedroom sets are not that expensive anymore. I got this bedroom set for like on sale for like $700 for the whole set. And don't mind my room, by the way. I still have to go interior decorating. I still have to go decor shopping because I need to get comforters. I literally just have my sheets. I want to get a painting up here. But this whole room is so pretty. I wish I could show you everything, but I want to do like a fully furnished apartment tour. Sorry. But yeah, make sure that you go. You have your furniture shopping, you have your money for your furniture, because like it took me a year to furnish that apartment that I told you guys I was struggling to pay so it took me like a year before I got a table, a freaking rug, like it was crazy. And I told myself I learned my lesson. And sometimes, you know, the worst feeling in the world, the worst experiences are your best teachers, your best lesson learned. Now that I moved in here, I have my stuff, you know what I'm saying? I still still gotta pay for my couch, but, and I have the money to get my couch, but like I said, I'd rather have money in my savings first, then when I get paid again, now, okay, I could pay for this, I could pay for that. Have that mentality, you're always gonna have money in your account. And also limit how you spend your money. Just because you have it don't mean you have to spend it. If you can, take the LIR instead of taking like Ubers everywhere, because $20-$30 adds up, and that could end up, that could be, you know, that money could go towards a bill, you know. And yeah, and tithe your money, tithe in church, you know what I'm saying? The more you give back, the more you will get back. And also just I feel like I said all the negative things about moving into your apartment, but you know, if you are moving into your apartment and you can't afford to move, and you're taking in all my advice, I just want to say congratulations on your new apartment, and tell me your experience. Tell me if you're experiencing some of the stuff that I've been telling you in this video, and you know, how are you liking it so far? Because my first place, I literally, like, that room for rent, it was so beautiful. Like, it didn't look like a room for rent. It, like I said, it was gorgeous. I wish I had pictures. Even in my second apartment, it was great. And now this apartment, I literally wake up every day before I go on, get on social media, anything. I pray and I tell God, thank you so much for allowing me to have my dream apartment. I remember when I had my room for rent, I used to pray for the same thing. Thank you, God, for allowing me to pay my own bills and to be out on my own. Because it does feel good to be on your own. Because in this life, you only got yourself. Don't look at your mom, your parents, and say, I'm always going to have them around. Because what if, God forbid, you don't have no parents? You want to make sure that, God forbid, your mom, your dad die, you know what I'm saying, you're good. You know how to pay rent. You know how to pay bills. And also, if you are starting out, don't get an apartment where you gotta pay for the utilities. Luckily for me, my utilities are really cheap because I know how to keep my bills down. Like I don't leave all the lights up in my house. I keep the thermostat on like 60 or something like that, 65, because it doesn't really get that cold in here. I know how to monitor the water and everything. My bill is super cheap. Like my cable bill, it's like, well, my cable was like $100-something, but my water bill, my light bill was like $20, $40 last month. I know how to keep it down, but if you're just moving into your new apartment, you're not going to really know these things. So definitely get an apartment with the utilities included. Usually you get utilities included when you live into like a private house. When you have apartment buildings, some apartments come with utilities included, but if it's not, don't get it, because if you don't have money like that, you're going to end up paying... like all your bills are just going to be a burden for you, and you're just not going to like your apartment no more, and you're going to be forced to move out, you know, because you can't afford it or get evicted. The last thing you want to do is get evicted. And that's pretty much what I have to say about tips on moving into your own apartment. This video was kind of long, but I feel like it was well needed. I have a lot of young supporters, and you guys really need to hear this, because it's no joke when you move into your apartment. It's gorgeous, it's beautiful, but you wanna make sure that your bills are paid. I can't stress this enough, and that you're making money. Save your money, having your money, have your rent money 2 months in advance. And if you can't, it's fine. Still take a majority of what you make, put it for your bills, put it in savings, and take like $300 or $400 for you. You know what I'm saying? Cause what can you possibly need like over $300 or $400 a month for? You know what I'm saying? And also, I advise that you cook. Okay, if you don't know how to cook, make sure you go grocery shopping, because food, believe it or not, can be your biggest expense, because you can't go a day without eating. You know, you know what I'm saying? You'll be really weak, or you'll just eventually die. So I noticed that my money was quickly going away, because, you know, I kept having to spend money on food because I refused to cook. But moving into my own apartment definitely taught me that, bitch, you better cook and save your coins. So now I've been cooking my own meals, and it's good to cook your own meals. You lose weight, you know what the hell is going into your food. So yeah, I hope I wasn't ranting for too much, and this was useful for you guys. And if it was, let me know, comment below. I love you so much. Until next time, Bella Gang. Mwah.